Buffalo Bills brought in a wide receiver. Should we expect anything out of Corey Coleman?
Here's what you should expect. More competition at that position. When you don't have talent, you don't know what you have outside, I guess, of Kelvin Benjamin, keep bringing players in. They got him on the cheap, seventh round pick. Look, if any organization is going to screw people up, it's the Browns. That doesn't make Corey Coleman good.
Yeah.
That means maybe it's not all on the player. Give him an opportunity. Let him run down the field and see what happens. But you've got such an open competition at wide receiver. Why not bring him in?
Quick fall from grace for this guy, right? Yeah, I mean, just 2 years ago.
But it's Cleveland. They don't have a single first-round pick left over from the last three seasons. Everything that happens at Cleveland is a quick fall from grace. And if you're Brandon Bean, I do love the reaction, right? The two sides of everyone. Nobody in the middle is like, this is a good move. Let's see what happens. Either we're going to the Super Bowl and Corey Coleman's the MVP, or this is the worst move ever. It's a seventh-round pick for a guy that was a first-round pick, and you're not cutting anybody spectacular if you end up keeping him. Of course you make this move. It's a good move. Why not?
Low risk, high reward. Did they not fleece the Browns? The Browns smoking. Seventh round pick for a guy they used a 15th overall pick. You look at his numbers at Baylor.
It's not fleecing if he gets cut.
I don't think he's getting cut. I don't think he is. I think he can play if he's healthy. He's missed what? He's had a broken hand, what, the last 2 years?
He's played 19 games in two seasons.
Oh, I'm sorry. When you said fleecing the Browns, I thought you were going to go back to third round pick for Tyrod Taylor.
Yeah. It's insane.
That is a fleecing.
That's a fleece. I mean, you think about it. And his number, when I watched him at Baylor, there's no question. Is he undersized? Yes. 5'11", but the guy can play, and he had huge numbers at Baylor. And I love when you look, you always head scratch when you take a player from a losing team. Had you come from New England, I feel a little bit better.
And
but
I,
the Browns are so dysfunctional. I love this move.
And you know, the whole idea is, well, we didn't draft him, so we move on for him.
Yeah.
Again, I'll put my Eagles hat on for a second. Nelson Aguilar, drafted by Chip Kelly right around the same time, was a bust. I mean, second year, total bust. They stuck with him. He worked at it. Bang, third year, he hits. The guy's going to end up getting a huge contract. If you're the Browns and you lack talent, you don't give up on young talent still in a rookie deal. I think it's more about them than it says about Coleman.
Well, how about the day after they trade Coleman, the guy that was supposed to replace Coleman gets caught with weed. So now he's going to get a four-game suspension. What are you doing? And then first episode of Hard Knocks airs this week. By the way, speaking of fleecing the Browns, you watch Hugh Jackson do his thing.
He's so bad. He's
it
so
makes
dumb.
Perfect sense as to what's been going on. But then Jarvis Landry, the star wide receiver in Cleveland who has a little bit of a work ethic issue, calls out the rest of the wide receiver room. What is going on?
That team why is Dez Bryant still out there?
He was a marginal player last year. He was marginal. No, he was a marginal player. Dallas has a terrible wide receiver situation now. They cut him loose. And even though you go ripping your owner, ripping your teammates, calling Sean Lee a snake.
Snake Lee.
I think
is that more
teams,
important than the fact that maybe he's not as good as he was?
I think if he was the same player but wasn't causing issues, I think somebody would have brought him in already.
He can't. He gets no separation whatsoever, number one. Number two, I don't think he can run anymore, right? Number three, he's got a big mouth.
Yeah.
If it's Antonio Brown or Odell Beckham, you can take the big mouth. I can't take it when you can't play.
Well, but hold on.
And you're
I don't think he's any good.
If you take the big mouth away, he signed immediately. It's what he did in the media that's keeping him from getting signed right now. Because listen, everyone's going to take a chance on a 6'5 guy that can go up and get a football, right? That's his play. He's going to go up and he's going to go get a ball. He can't get separation. He's not fast, but it's what he did that is keeping him from getting signed.
Yeah. And again, your career goes longer if you're a good guy.
He needs to go to a team that has an established quarterback and established head coach. Now, Green Bay would make some sense.
Yeah.
Green Bay, man, he can't go to a team that has a young quarterback and a young coach.
Right.
That would be cancer.
It was never considered by Buffalo. Never considered.
No, I don't think so.
Well, but Bean did address it. Somebody asked him. He said, we're not closing that door. He didn't say we're not looking at him.
Right. Okay. He hasn't closed the door on
he's
you
gotta
coming
go to
in
a
at
place once.
If it's
it.
Like he can help.
He's got to go to a team where he's a two or a third option. He still thinks he's a number one.
Yeah.
He's not.